Hi everyone, welcome to Adonia Academy. This is Maria here and it's so good to see you again. If you're new to my channel, please do subscribe and hit that bell icon so that you get notified when I upload a new video every week. This week, let me show you how I made this cute, naughty monster cake. I used 3 cakes. 2 6-inch round cakes and 1 6-inch dome cake, which I baked in my dome pan. Recipe for the cakes and frosting and links to buy all the tools which I've used in this video is in the description box, so please do check that out. I start by stacking my cakes and filling them with cream cheese frosting. Then I go on to give a light crumb coat with the same frosting. Since this is a tall cake, just for extra stability, I've secured it with wooden skewers. Then go on to crumb coat your cake and put it in the fridge to set for about half an hour to 45 minutes. Then we go on to make our fondant detailing. With 2 balls of light blue fondant, I'm going on to make the ears, or I don't know, the front, I don't know what they call, they look like the ears. Take a lollipop stick, brush it with edible glue and stick these 2 balls into it. Set it aside so that they completely dry. Recipe for edible glue and my homemade gum paste is also in the description box below. I next go on to make the legs, the small feet of the monster. Start by shaping 2 large pieces of light blue fondant into a teardrop shape. Press them and with your sharp X-acto knife, mark 2 lines like so. Set it aside to dry. Next, roll out a piece of white fondant, a piece of blue fondant, and a piece of black fondant. This is to cut the eyes. Take 2 circle cutters and cut the white and blue pieces like so. Stick them one on top of each other using water or edible glue. Lastly, cut out a small round black fondant. I've used a nozzle, the back of the nozzle, and put them into place like so. Next, I go on to cut out the mouth. Using a large cookie cutter, cut out a semicircle like so. Then cut out 3 small rectangles out of white fondant for the teeth and stick them into place like so. Now let's start piping the spikes of the little monster. I've dyed my buttercream into 2 colors, light green and dark green, and start piping the spikes first from the top and then I move on to the bottom. I'm using a large star tip. You can use a 1mm tip or a 2D tip, whatever you have. Press and pull, press and pull, making sure that you don't leave any gaps in between. Then halfway through, stick the mouth like so in position and continue piping. At this point, I remembered I had to put the feet, so I changed the cake onto a bigger board to accommodate the feet, put the feet in position and continue piping. Yes, it's a lot of piping. I really like piping. Let me know in the comments if you enjoy piping or not. I've used American buttercream, but you can use whipped cream, white chocolate ganache, or any other meringue buttercream too. So continue piping till you finish the entire cake. Once it's complete, I added a few more spikes on top so that, you know, it just doesn't look very uniform and in line. There, all done. Now just add its eyes into position and its ears. I still don't know whether they are ears or what. Whatever it is, doesn't this guy look absolutely squishy and huggable and cute? If you think so too, please give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, it's free and you get to see a lot more videos. Don't forget to hit the bell button to get notified when I upload a new video every week. Let me know in the comments what more kind of videos you would like to see. Until next time, take care of yourself. Bye.